Hello everyone, welcome to Achievers IAS classes. Today we are here to discuss the current events of the day, that is 13th December 2017. Let's start with the national issues of the day. The first issue is regarding setting up of a constitutional bench to hear the plea whether Jallikattu and other bullock cart races constitute the cultural right of the people. This is in response to various petitions filed before the Supreme Court led by the People for Ethical Treatment of Animals organization to squash the new Jallikattu law passed by the Tamil Nadu Assembly, according to which bulls are brought under the category of performing animals, thereby legalizing Jallikattu. We are all aware of the huge protests in Tamil Nadu last year regarding the ban on Jallikattu and the centers promulgation of an ordinance owing to the pressure from Tamil Nadu. The Constitution under Article 29 protects the educational and cultural rights of any sections of the society having a distinct language, script or culture. However, the practice of Jallikattu in the recent years is seen as cruelty against these animals due to the inhuman conditions to which they are subjected. We will look into the issue in further detail once the final judgment of the Supreme Court is out. With that, let's move on to the next issue in news today, which is regarding the Right to Information Act and its applicability to the higher judiciary. The issue is in news because the Delhi High Court has recently ruled that the provisions under the Right to Information Act cannot override the Supreme Court rules when it comes to information sharing with the public. The Delhi High Court has differentiated between the judicial and administrative function of the judiciary and has further clarified that the provisions under the Right to Information Act would be applicable to the judicial functioning of the court, but the administrative functioning of the judiciary is subject to the Supreme Court rules, which means no litigant can seek information through an RTI application questioning the judicial administrative activities as to why or what reasons has prompted the judge to come at a particular decision or conclusion. In simpler words, a judge is not bound to explain his or her decisions to the public. This judgment is in response to the plea against the order of the Central Information Commission, which had ordered the court to answer the queries of a litigant whose special leave petition was dismissed. And through this judgment, the judiciary has made it clear that the legislature, even by law, cannot take away the judicial powers of the court. This has various negative implications for the Right to Information Act itself. As we know, the Right to Information Act ushered in an era of transparency and accountability in governance, and the judiciary, through its various judgments, has brought various authorities under the ambit of this act. But the refusal of the judiciary to bring itself under the ambit of the act is a blatant disregard for the RTI, thereby refusing information to the public. This is a big setback to the RTI act because, as we know, the political parties have always refused to come under the ambit of RTI, and judiciary, by not bringing itself under the ambit of RTI, has set a wrong precedent. With that, let's move on to the next issue in news today, which is regarding the constitution of special courts to exclusively look into the criminal cases involving members of parliament and members of legislative assemblies of states, which is a result of the Supreme Court's direction to the union government to frame a central scheme for setting up special courts across the country to try cases involving political persons. According to the Supreme Court, these special courts are needed because it would take years to complete a trial against a politician, by which time the tainted politician would have served as a minister or a legislator several times. This is a welcome move so far as cleaning up the democratic process is concerned, but also raises question on equality of access to justice. With that, Let's move on to the next issue in news today, which is regarding the electronic voting machines used by the Election Commission. The question over the credibility of the electronic voting machines against tampering will time and again pop up, especially around the time of elections. And it is no different during the Gujarat elections, where the EC has again reasserted the robust security and administrative protocols which make the electronic voting machines tamper-proof. UPSC has previously asked questions both in prelims as well as mains on various constitutional, statutory and executive bodies. As we know, the Election Commission of India is a constitutional body established under the provisions of Article 324 to conduct elections to Parliament, State Legislatures, Office of President and Vice President. With that, let's move on to the next issue in news today, which is regarding the ongoing ministerial conference of the World Trade Organization. As we know, India has time and again asserted that there can't be any new issues which can be brought up for discussions at the WTO until the commitments under the Doha Development Agenda are met, which includes a permanent solution to the public stockholding program of developing nations. And this stance of India is unchanged in the ongoing conference. However, countries like Pakistan and China have demanded to take the discussions further on investment facilitation. I have discussed the issue in detail as well as the various challenges in front of the WTO questioning its credibility in my previous news analysis videos. I request those who have missed it to go back and watch the same. With that, let's move on to the next issue in news today, which is regarding the recent 2+2 dialogue between Australia and India. The two countries discussed on various issues, and the prominent among them is regarding the freedom of navigation in the South China Sea, given growing Chinese assertiveness in the region. The two countries have also discussed the importance of maintaining a free and open zone in the Asia-Pacific region, which constitutes the area as highlighted in the map. This is because both the countries share common interests in maintaining freedom of navigation in the Indo-Pacific region, both due to strategic as well as economic interests. And the recent dialogue only highlights the growing convergence in interests between India and Australia. With that, let's move on to the next issue in news today, which is regarding the recent calls given by the leader of the terrorist organization Hezbollah to focus on fighting Israel. This can be seen as a reaction to the controversial remarks made by US President recognizing Jerusalem as the capital of Israel. I have covered the issue in depth in my previous videos, and I request those who have missed it to go back and watch the same. Which is regarding the rejection of Supreme Court to provide equal protection to Vande Mataram as that provided to our national anthem. We can expect a question in the prelims examination regarding when the Vande Mataram song was first sung and its author. So please go back and revise the same. The other issues in news include the challenge of Mr. Sharad Yadav against his disqualification from Rajya Sabha in the Delhi High Court. I have discussed the various provisions under the Anti-Defection Act and the shortcomings in this particular case. So please go back and watch the same in my previous news analysis videos. The final issue in news today is regarding the ongoing negotiations between EU and Brexit, which also I have discussed in depth regarding the reasons which led to Brexit and its implications on India. And I request those who have missed it to go back and watch the same. With that, I'm wrapping up today's news analysis. Please do like, share and comment to support this initiative. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.